I'm Father Marcus Lashley, and I welcome you to these sacred spaces, which reflect the understanding of those who have worshipped in these places and are now no longer with us, as well as those who continue to draw closer to God in our time. Major Lubin, Austin, Robinson, Charleston, Maxwell, Charlie as we call him, chose to spend many hours in these two places of worship, sometimes alone, bathed in the light of the Real Presence lamp, sometimes in the presence of hundreds of worshipers, or at times with his maintenance crew. He understood that it is God's sacramental presence that makes these churches a home. And he was truly at home in church. As an engineer, he was in awe of the craftsmanship of the many artisans that built them, but equally conscious of his duty to maintain them and to hand on to the next generation of Christians a place worthy of God's most holy name. He began his Christian life and walk at the font. He joined his voice with those who occupied the choir stalls. And as one of the licensed lay readers in our cathedral, he conveyed God's word as on a platter of gold. At every dusk in service, it was his pride and delight to be serving beside successive bishops and deans. Now that some of the grief of his sudden passing has subsided, his relatives, friends, and colleagues have chosen to move from grief to gratitude and to celebrate his life and witness in music. We have many memories of Charlie, and these will be shared and reflected in his capacity as a man of faith, a military man, and a family man. Let us now enter into this solemn remembrance, focusing on the God who gave Charlie to us, and in whose nearer presence he now rests. In Holy Baptism, a pledge was given on Charlie's behalf, and he renewed it in his confirmation. The pledge was to continue to be God's faithful soldier and servant to the end of his life. In gratitude, we now light this candle in his memory and pray that the serenity of its light may warm our hearts and focus our minds. Let us pray. Let's pray the prayer which is attributed to St. Bede. We seem to give them back to thee, O God, who gavest them first to us. Yet as thou didst not lose them in giving, so we do not lose them by their return. Not as the world giveth, givest thou, O lover of souls. What thou givest, thou takest not away. For what is thine is ours also, if we are thine. And life is eternal, and love is immortal. And death is only an horizon. And an horizon is nothing save the limit of our sight. Lift us up, strong Son of God, that we may see further. Cleanse our eyes that we may see more clearly. Draw us closer to thyself that we may know ourselves, to be nearer to our loved ones who are with thee. And while thou dost prepare a place for us, prepare us also for that happy place, that where thou art, we may be also forevermore. Amen.
Hold his own son, but gave him up for all of us. Will he not with him also give us everything else? Who will bring any charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? It is Christ Jesus, who died, yes, who was raised, who is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. Who will separate us from the love of Christ? Will hardship, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? As it is written, for your sake, we are being killed all day long. We are accounted as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus, our Lord.
Thank you. A reading from the Word of God, written in the book of Isaiah, the 40th chapter, beginning at the 28th verse. Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint and strengthens the powerless. Even youths will faint and be weary, and the young will fall exhausted. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
How long will the pain last? A broken-hearted mourner asked. All the rest of your life, I have to answer truthfully. We never quite forget. No matter how many years pass, we remember. The loss of a loved one is like a major operation. Part of us is removed, and we have a scar for the rest of our life. As years go by, we manage. There are things to do, people to care for, tasks that call for full attention, but the pain is still there, not far below the surface. We see a face that looks familiar, hear a voice that echoes, see a photograph in someone's album, see a landscape that we once saw together. And it seems as though a knife were in the womb again, but not so painful, and mixed with joy too, because remembering a happy time is not all sorrow, it brings happiness with it. How long will the pain last? All the rest of your life. But the thing to remember is that not only the pain will last, but the blessed memories as well. Tears are a proof of life. The more love, the more tears. If this be true, then how could we ask that pain cease altogether? For then the memories of love will go with it. The pain of grief is the price we pay for love.
Lord, we pray for your world, and especially today for all who recall the life of Lubin, Austin, Robinson, Charleston, Maxwell. God of time and eternity, we remember Lubin, who died on this day 3 years ago. As he remains in our love, though parted from us, we pray that you will keep him in your perfect and infinite care, and that one day we may enjoy friendship with each other in your nearer presence, where every tear shall be wiped away. Amen. We pray for strength and hope for all who mourn. Lord of all life, whose Son taught, blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Look with compassion and gentleness on all who mourn this day. Inspire them with your hope when the future seems empty, and strengthen them with your love, that they may believe in that life which their friends now enjoy, and come to know the fullness and riches of life for themselves once again, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. With God, there is mercy and fullness of redemption. Let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Word of God written in the fourth chapter of the letter of Paul to the Philippians, beginning at verse 4. Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say rejoice. Let your gentleness be known to everyone. The Lord is near. Do not worry about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, beloved, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is pleasing, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence, and if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing the things that you have learned and received and heard and seen in me, and the God of peace will be with you. The word of the Lord.
Jesus. Let us pray. Father of all, by whose mercy and grace your saints remain in everlasting light and peace, we remember with thanksgiving those whom we love but see no longer. And we pray that in them your perfect will may be fulfilled. Through Jesus Christ, O Lord. Amen. O God, whose days are without end, and whose mercies cannot be numbered, make us, we pray, deeply aware of the shortness and uncertainty of human life, and let your Holy Spirit lead us in holiness and righteousness all our days, that when we shall have served you in all generation, we may be gathered to our ancestors, having a testimony of a good conscience, in the communion of the Catholic Church, in the confidence of a certain faith, in the comfort of a religious and holy hope, in favor with you, our God, and in perfect charity with the world. All this we ask through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Unto him that is able to keep us from falling, and to present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever. Amen. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.